I made a video recently challenging Meshy.AI to create some 3D models of ocean creatures. And in this one, I thought I'd push it a little further and see if I could actually generate models for a real project. And so I'm going to focus this time on creating anatomical models that might be used in a medical illustration project. This will be a shorter video. I'm basically just going to cut to the chase and show you the results that I get from the prompts that I input. So I have no idea what's going to happen. Let's find out. All right, so we're in Meshy.ai again, and I've got 200 credits back up, and I'm going to go to the text to 3D prompt. You can see my previous model generations in here. This time, I'm going to try creating some anatomical models. So I've typed in a new prompt: accurate, realistic model of a human heart, including all the vessels and anatomical structures. High resolution, high quality, a color from Netter Atlas of Human Anatomy. Netter Atlas, for those who don't know, is basically the industry standard in terms of representation and color and medical illustration and anatomical modeling. So that's why I'm putting that reference in there. And I'm not going to put any negative prompts or anything like that. I just want to see what happens. So here we go. I have to say, I'm kind of surprised at how good this looks so far. Wow. Okay. So here's the base model without any texturing or refined texturing. It's actually fairly accurate. It's not perfect. None of these are going to be perfect. I just can't imagine it's going to be capable of doing that. But they all at least look fairly heart-like. This one's missing some vessels. The coloration on this one seems a little bit more accurate. Also, sort of missing some vessels. I'm just going to pick one and go ahead and refine it and see what happens. So I'm just going to choose this first one and go ahead and see what happens when we generate the refined model. Okay, so the model has finished doing texturing, and the texturing is obviously not going to be usable at all. So that didn't work out in any way. I wanted to bring over this image of an actual heart illustration and just kind of compare it side by side here. So you can see sort of that comparison of the vessels, and the vessels are not accurately placed, right? So using something like this in an illustration or an animation is actually kind of dangerous, right? Because these models are not accurate. The vessels are not coming out of the appropriate places. The chambers do not look accurate. The structure of the vessels that wrap around the heart and feed the heart are not accurate. And so I guess this is just a caution, like, do not use Meshy.AI's models in an actual medical illustration, because you will be burned. That is not a good idea. I on the one hand, I'm kind of impressed because it does look relatively heart-like, but it's definitely not a human heart, and it is definitely not accurate. So I'm going to call this a fail. Okay, next up, we're going to do a human torso. So let's see. I've got some prompts sort of pre-typed in here, so you don't have to watch me type. And I thought I would try a human torso with the skin removed to show the underlying muscular anatomy. And again, I always put this high resolution, high quality, and derive the color from the Netter Atlas of Human Anatomy. So we'll generate this and see what we get. So once again, I'm not nearly as surprised by these being a little bit more accurate. Because Meshy does seem to be pretty good at doing human anatomy already. This would need some very serious sort of study to check every set of muscles to make sure it's accurate. But what I'm not seeing here is any sort of muscle tissue. This is kind of like a nude torso model, not really the muscle anatomy itself, which is what I was looking for. This does not look like it has the skin removed. It looks like the skin is still on there, so it didn't really do what I asked. Some of these have like thong underwear on. I think of all of them, this is the one I would probably choose, and I'm just going to go ahead and generate a refined mesh and texture map just because I'm curious to see what happens. Okay, so this is finished. It's refined version, and this is what we've got. So, I mean, on the one hand, I love this. I think it is creepy and interesting, but absolutely not anywhere close to being a representation of accurate human anatomy in terms of the textures and even in some terms of some of the forms, although the forms are pretty close. So I'd say once again, the refined models in Meshy are not going to be replacing medical illustrators or anatomical modelers or texture artists right now. So use with caution. It's kind of creepy. Okay. Next up, we have. I thought it would be fun to try to make a human eye model and see what we could get with that. So, accurate, realistic model of a right of, I'll say, I'll let Grammarly tell me what to do. Of. Okay, thank you, Grammarly, for making me a better typer. A realistic model of the human right eye in the socket of the skull, including eye muscles and all anatomical structures and all of that. So let's see what happens. Wow. It's an eye that has a skull on it. Now, maybe my prompts just need some more work, but this is what I was kind of hoping to get is something like this with a model of the eye with the muscles around it in the skull. This is a scientific model that you can actually purchase for like $600, like a physical model. So that's what I was looking for. I'm not even going to refine these because they're ridiculous, but this is by far my favorite. So, okay, that wraps up my Meshy.AI test to see if it can actually make realistic anatomical models to use in medical illustration and animation projects. And I'm going to say right now it is a resounding no, absolutely not. Thanks for watching.